Have you ever stopped to think about first words? First words can be powerful and memorable. Whether it's the first words that a baby utters, the first words of a great piece of literature, or the first words of a famous speech. First words can take a long time to ponder and to develop. If you've ever written a cover letter for a job, a difficult sympathy note to a dear friend, or an important presentation for a professional meeting, you know how difficult it can be to write that first sentence. First words give so much away. They set a tone for what is to follow. They serve as a promise, a sort of handshake, or a key to what is yet to come. The first words uttered by God in the book of Genesis, like other first words, give a lot away about God. God's first words are, "Let there be light." These four words offer us critical insight into who God is. God is a God of light, one who dispels darkness. As we read further, we learn that the light is a symbol for all that is true, righteous, good, and holy. In the season of Advent, which we begin this week, light becomes a powerful symbol of anticipation and hope. The true light casting out all darkness. One familiar sight of the Advent season is the Advent wreath. There's a very interesting story of the origin of the Advent wreath that I'd like to share with you. It has long been suspected that the Advent wreath was adopted by Christians from a practice by farmers in pre-Christian Scandinavia. At the end of the growing season each year, Scandinavian farmers were known to remove the wheels from their farming carts, and they decorate them with evergreens and place lit candles on the wreath during the dark days before the winter solstice in an attempt to entice the sun to return. And they prayed to the God of light to turn the wheel of the earth back toward the sun to lengthen the days and restore the warmth. Not unlike these early Scandinavians, Christian Advent wreaths are decorated with various evergreens, signifying continuous life. The circle of the wreath, which has no beginning or end, symbolizes the eternity of God. The four candles represent the 4 weeks of Advent. The progressive lighting of the candles symbolizes the expectation and hope surrounding Jesus' coming into the world and his ongoing presence with us. Every year, as Christians celebrate the Advent and Christmas season, those of the Jewish faith celebrate Hanukkah. Years ago, I had a Jewish colleague. Our work involved a lot of business travel. I can remember several times when we would be traveling during the celebration of Hanukkah. My colleague always offered to include me in the lighting of the small travel-sized menorah and the reciting of the prayer, to which I was happy to join her. The celebration of Advent and Christmas season and Hanukkah have the common theme of bringing light into the world. The convergence of these two great lights affords us the opportunity to double the light and to cast out the darkness. As we light the first candle of the Advent wreath, this candle of hope, let us pray for light and hope for our broken world. So let us pray. We pray for more light in a world where there is too much darkness, for greater understanding between all people of the world. We pray for unity in a world of divisiveness, for comfort and healing in a world with too much pain and suffering. We pray for warmth in a world that at times is cold and harsh. We pray for peace in our hearts and for peace in our world. Let us commit ourselves today to illuminate the dark places, filling them with light, candle by candle. Amen.